The following morning, Les joins some of the others at breakfast. Knocked out by the detox drugs, Les had a good night's sleep.
Okay, I slept really well. I slept really well once I found the empty room next to the one that Les and I are sharing. It's Les likes to.
The clients will be staying for 2 weeks, but on the clinic's advice, have an option to stay for a further two. Les's last drink was over 48 hours ago, and now it's time to meet Dr. Laurie Weber for his first psychotherapy session.
Today, I'm going to ask you a lot of questions, so if it gets to be too much, just let me know, just so I can get a sense kind of who you are, or you can tell me.
It's pretty strange, because if I'm in a mood like this, not a mood, but in an environment like this, then I want to tell you jokes and stuff like that.
Of course.
And I don't want to talk about anything else.
Okay. So how long have you been drinking?
I've been drinking heavily since 2002 or 2003.
Okay, so why since then?
Well, I'm going by a bunch of things that people have said to me, like during this, the build-up to speaking to you, that quite a lot of it may have been down to my lifetime of disappointments, culminating in the straw that broke the camel's back, let's say, was my losing my father.
In
2004. My father was deaf and dumb, so he couldn't quite understand everything that was going around any particular subject. So if my oldest brother got in trouble, he just took it the way he took it, and he beat him within an inch of his life many a time.
And your dad never hit you?
My dad never hit me in a way, a conventional hitting. He would sit me down and he would get his big bunch of keys and he would straighten your legs and he would smack them over your knees, and that's...
With the keys?
Yeah. So he never, like, punched me in the face or tried to rip my neck off or break my arms. That was the punishment. It was a set punishment.
Were you afraid?
Yeah.
Growing up?
Yeah, I was very afraid of my father when I knew I'd done something wrong. But in the normal course of things, I loved my father in bits.
Okay.
It was kind of awkward having cameras in there and stuff. It's going to take a little bit of time to get used to knowing that other people are listening to our darkest little secrets.
It's Tuesday of the first week, and on the schedule for some of the group is physical training.
Push them out to here.
The aim is to get the group to rebuild physical strength lost through years of addiction.
Do you do any type of exercise right now at all?
Apart from that.
The bicep curl? All right, we'll break that one. I'm going to back you up just a little bit. How does that distance feel?
Yeah, it feels all right. I seem like I've been here on a bit of a holiday so far. There's nothing much to do in between these sessions. But they've just been talking about how great passages it is. And I'm thinking, if it doesn't get any better, I'll probably go home early.
But later that day, a disgruntled Les meets with spiritual therapist Audrey Hope.
So I need you to close your eyes and just imagine this light going through your body, Les, okay? Just imagine it going down through your body. I want you to call in all the people who hurt you or who took something from you. People in your life that are still living with you, energetically with you, that follow you around. And I want you to tell me the heaviest one that's living inside your body, the one that has the most cord, as they say, connected to you. And who is it attached to?
Don't want to tell you.
Who?
I don't want to tell you.
Oh, you don't want to tell. Okay, I want you to put that person in front of you. I want you to tell this person that today is your day, you're getting free. You're not going to let them live there anymore.
Some people are a little more difficult. But if you work long enough, there's always a hook.
There's always a place you can go in, see? So I'm always looking, even though I'm asking questions, I'm always looking. I use my intuition to find what it is. Where do you feel the pain in your body, Les? Go into it now. What does it look like in there? Is it dark? Is it ugly?
It's definitely ugly.
Definitely ugly. Is it a monster in there?
Yeah.
Les is not suffering from what he thinks he's suffering from. But he needs to know that by coming here is courageous.